I'll say Jamie Redknapp. You want to go out with your girlfriend or your wife and you say, like, we're leaving at 8 o'clock and they're still doing their hair and the makeup at 8:15 and the taxi's waiting on the drive and the booking at the restaurant is 8:15 and you're still in the house because she's doing her makeup and her foundation and finishing off her hair and it drives you mad. That's probably what he was like.
John Arnerisa. But I've noticed Cara started wearing wax on Sky Sports, so he might take that mantle.
Certainly, it would have been good to you play for Real Madrid. He's now coach of the under. I think he's coach of the under 18/19s over there. He was never out of a mirror.
Oh, Guti at Real Madrid. I hope he's not playing against us. He'll probably kick me for it, but definitely him. He had a mirror right next to his space in the dressing room.
I used to get changed in the dressing room, the old dressing room, next to Graham Souness. I'm going to say Graham simply because next to Graham was a mirror. And he couldn't help walking by the mirror without looking into it and going, nice, nice, I like that, yeah.
I'd say Cara, probably. Cara's not bothered about anything apart from football, but certainly not the way he looks or anything else like that. So, or he wasn't, anyway, he's starting to smarten up a bit in his old age, but he certainly wasn't, he was, yeah. He was not bothered about much when he was younger.
He used to be Cara, but since he started going into the showbiz world, I've noticed he's taken a few of his greys out and adding a bit of wax to that basic carpet he's wearing. So Cara's taken that over, I think.
You know, I've never been a fan of German fashion, you know. So Didi Hamanas didn't spend a great deal of time, you know, on how his dress was. And I think that's just a German thing in general. I'm not trying to have a go at the manager or anything, but the German fashion's never been my favourite.
Well, I didn't play with Didi, but I know Didi very well. Can I have him in my answer? He's the least vain person I know. We had to take him to the doctors once to get a jumper removed because we had it on that long.
No, I used to just have to get my fringe out my eyes. I had that long fringe when it used to go in my eyes, so I used to have to just stick a bit of product on to keep that out the way, and then I was out there, I was done.
You always want to look your best on match day. You know the TV cameras are there. You know you're playing in front of a lot of people and you're meeting a lot of people and you're doing media, so you do want to look your best. So I think a haircut, you know, every couple of weeks was probably in order. You know, I would always make sure my hair was done before I went out to play.
I always put something in my hair, so I've got some form of wax or whatever. That's a grooming product that I can't go without. And after I shower or shave, then I can get a little bit dry, so I would always moisturise.
Hair wax. Got to be, because my hair just grows straight forward like that.
Moisturiser. And if you're going to put it on, do it with these fingers. Hold on. Then fingers, because they're the softest pads, and you dab it on. You don't rub it, you dab.
Talk about vanity. I use all the creams on my pan and that, you know, now. I've been doing it for a good 10 years. My missus got me into it. You've got to, haven't you?